nice and mellowed out here because I was just excited. I just had so many things that I wanted to share with you guys. So now about transformation. As you guys know, I went through a personal transformation myself, and it really consisted of me just discovering what my gems are, what it is that I possess, and that I can give to the world 100% and authentically. And I have to say, it was probably, actually, no, it's not probably, it was the best thing that could ever happen to me, because it allowed me to get honest with myself. It allowed me to really dig deep and find the things that I love. It allowed me to go back to a time that I was extremely happy and stay in that bliss. And it allowed me to really just share more of myself with the world. So I feel that it's an amazing thing for anyone and everyone to try or to at least do. And I want to share this with the world. So moving forward, I am growing into more of a transformation slash business coach, because what I want to do is I want to help you get in the mindset of a business owner. I want you to get rid of those blocks. I want you to, you know, set yourself a schedule and structure. I want you to succeed. I don't want to see you flopping around trying to figure out what's your next move, you know? And that is why I wanted being in transformation business coaching and to like just let you guys know what it is. So as you guys know, a little bit about my past is I have a business with my partner, AKA fiance Tony. And at the beginning, things were going really smoothly. You know, we kind of just like threw it all together and did it. I was lucky that Tony already had some stuff already in the motions. I just kind of came in and polished it up. But really, the whole thing really made me just go back and understand who I was, you know, because I have to present myself to a lot of people and I'm not working for anyone. So there wasn't a brand or a company to hide behind. It was just me and Tony. So it had to be 100% honest and who we are for us to succeed. It wasn't like, oh, you work for guests and I like guests, so I'm just gonna automatically like you. You know what I'm saying? It was like, I was the business, he was the business, and we had to step up our game and be business owners. So that is where this love of transformation comes from, because it's allowed me to get in touch with who I am and present myself in a way that I've always wanted to present myself, but I was afraid to present myself this way because I thought people wouldn't understand me, or people wouldn't accept me, or maybe I just wasn't comfortable with being myself. But it was very difficult for me in the past. I tried it at least 4 times. I tried to start like 3 businesses on my own. I tried to be an event planner. I tried to be a fashion show planner, and I tried to be a stylist. And all of those things, I would get like so far. And then when it became real, I'd go and run and get a job. And then I'd be like, I can't do this. And I get a job and get comfortable, make the money, and then I would just forget about my dream. I mean, I'm sure you guys have heard this, right? Or you've gone through this cycle as well, where, okay, it's a lot easier to go with a job and someone who's just going to hand you money rather than you go out and struggle and feel the pain and the uncomfortableness and, you know, and just like, ugh, who wants to feel that, right? But the thing that I didn't realize is that is just a phase. That comes to an end. That is where it gets real, because you have to really want it and you have to be real with yourself. So that was my biggest wake-up call when I started working with Tony, is that, okay, we're doing this, and I'm meeting a lot of big high level people, and I'm a very still young minded person, young girl, and not comfortable with dealing with authority figures and being held accountable for large sums of money. Okay, I gotta figure this out. So I basically just took some time to figure out who I was and what it is that I needed to do in order to become the woman that I knew was inside my soul and I knew that was inside me, but I needed her to come out to the world. So that was the first part of my transformation. I was never really committed to the new me. I was always partially committed to the new me. So with transformation coaching, you're going to be able to fully commit to the new you, understand what it is that's stopping you from going over that hump, over that pain, what it is that you need to do personally, what you need to get in touch with personally to get to the full transformation. And for me, it was just really embracing that I have special gifts and that I am worthy of being a business owner and living in my bliss. And that's when it all turned around for me, when I saw, when I did the visualization practice, and I saw my higher self and I spoke with her and I got to meet her, and I was just like, oh my God, she's beautiful. This is who I want to be. This is where I'm going. This is what's in my soul. Oh my God, it was the best feeling ever. And I've kept that vision with me ever since. That's what helps me keep going. So transformation is seeing your higher self, going within, understanding that you have a higher calling, you have a higher being that is going to take you further. And you're either going to get there through like a superly, super, super, super painful situation, or you're going to get there by force. So you're either going to get there between those two things. So you might as well take the opportunity to practice the transformation course, or practice any kind of transformation things that you can find, or if you want, you can work with me and just take it now, do it now. Become the hero that you feel that you are inside. Be that. Don't keep hiding, don't keep pushing it off. You know, get some structure, get an accountability partner, get someone that's going to help you go all the way. And that's what transformation did for me. It helped me just really get out of my own way and really go. There was so much that was challenging at the beginning of my journey, and I really didn't even know where to start, but I knew that I had to start with me. I knew that if I made the change, everything else around me would change. I knew that if there was problems, this took a little bit longer, but eventually it came around to where if there were problems, why were there problems? Not because the world was raining problems on me, not because so-and-so was bringing problems on me, it's because I was allowing that. I was bringing that on myself. And why was I bringing that on myself? I was bringing that on myself because that's my comfort and I was okay with it. And I was just like, problems, good. Because why? I can hide behind that. You can't see me. You can't see that I'm scared. You can't see that I'm fragile. You can't see that I'm a sensitive individual and I'm an empath and I feel all of it. You can't see that because I'm just going to hide behind these problems, and I'm going to hide behind the fact that I want you to like me. So I'm just going to stay cool and just go under the radar. And